good segue. There is a man up there, and that's John Wesley. And our and he's what's he doing? Yeah, but what's different this week? Do you see something different? Well, he's kind of doing like this.
Never thought of that.
Yeah, and what do you suppose he's doing? He could be praying, he could be preaching, he could be blessing.
He's blessing.
He could be blessing, yep. And what's he standing on?
A box.
Can you read what that box says?
London.
And what's the other word? So today's story about John Wesley is that John Wesley preached in an old factory that used to make cannonballs. They call that a foundry because it uses metal. And he was so short he had to stand on a box to preach because he was like even shorter than I was. Wasn't he 5'2"? Yeah, he's even shorter than me. He was pretty short. So he would stand and he would preach in this old abandoned factory, and thousands of people would come and listen to him. And so eventually what they did is they bought that old factory and they turned it into a meeting house for people who came to hear him preach. And and so back to the story. And so in this place, they would worship and they would preach and they would teach and they would meet in small groups. And then they began to learn about how to share the love of God. And they would share the love of God with themselves, but they'd also share it with the neighbors in London. And some of the ways they did that, you can see up there in ways that we do it. You notice there's a bread and a cup. What's that all about? It's bread and cup. What is it, Miles? It's communion. It sure is. It's communion, and that's what we celebrate. And there's also behind that, do you see that kind of a wooden thing back behind it? That's like this one. It's a baptismal font. So they offered Jesus to the people, but they also offered other things that the people needed. What do you suppose a blanket is for? If people are cold, yes. And we have a blanket ministry here where we give out blankets. And then do you see what's over in the corner? What's in the corner? In a basket. Fruits and vegetables. So they offered them food. Exactly. And then there's a backpack up there. We have a garden ministry and a backpack ministry. And that's how, and that's how we share God's love to the people of our neighborhood. So what was happening is that as people came to love God, they reached out to share that love in ways that people needed, either food or clothing or loans. And that really became an important way that Methodists shared God's love. So when you see John Wesley standing up there, he's offering more than a sermon. What he's done in his ministry is he's offering help for a broken world, for people who have problems. Does anybody here have problems? Oh, yeah, we do. All of us have a problem of some kind, right? And that's the way that we address those problems, by sharing God's love and addressing the problems and the needs of the people. So let's tell Jesus thank you for the opportunity to share his love. Would you pray with me? Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For the opportunity.
For the opportunity.
To share your love.
To share your love.
Help us share it with each other. And share it with others.
Share it with others.
Who are in our neighborhood.
Who are in our neighborhood.
And our schools.
And our schools.
And our hospitals.
Our hospitals.
And wherever there are needs.
Wherever there are needs.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For making us whole people.
Making us whole people.